Hi guys, welcome back. Today I am doing a little journal with me. I was just pointing out this beautiful coffee dyed paper and this beautiful big mark on the side of the page there. I just love it. I think it's so beautiful. I am sticking in a few photos to start off with. That's often how I start off in my journal spreads. I will often start with the kind of bigger items first, which is often my photos. And I was at this point working on Heart Musing with Crystal's challenge, where she was challenging us to only use supplies that we've made or altered ourselves. So I was only using things that I'd made or altered myself, and that was a real challenge. I really enjoyed it. It really pushed me, but it was definitely not something that was easy. So what I'm doing here is I'm going through these sort of like painted little random images that I'd made and trying to decide what exactly I wanted to use on the page to add a little more visual interest, because just those photos wasn't doing it for me. The photos, especially the one of my niece in the bath there, so cute, but I wanted something a little more to add to this page. So I was just picking through them. I've got so many of them here, trying to decide which ones I wanted to add on, what ones were going to work best here on this page. And I, in the end, go for a random orange chicken and a little heart. So you will see me pull them out very soon, I am sure. So on this day, it was my sister and brother-in-law's wedding anniversary. So James and I were down at their house to babysit little Freya so that they could go out for dessert. It was just late in the evening. We went down there after dinner and they wanted to go out for dessert to the place where they got married. And so we were going to look after Freya while she was asleep. We did get to see her a little bit while she was awake, which was nice, but we were going down there just to be there. And they got to go out and have a nice dessert together. So that was lovely. And it's always so nice to hang out with Freya and obviously the rest of my family too. But it's very fun hanging out with Freya. She's such a joy. She's such a light. And I just think she's so cute. I'm very biased. But she is. And this day I was also posting off my Patreon mail. You can see in the picture there with the little envelopes. That was my Patreon mail was going out that day. And I also had posted a YouTube video of Scrapbusting and DIY journal cards, which if you haven't seen it yet, I will try and link that below or somewhere. And you can go and check that one out too, because that's also a fun video to watch. I'm just going around the edge here of this page with my Tombow. Sometimes I don't do this very often, but I actually do like how it looks. Kind of adding that border right around the edge of the page. I think that's quite fun. And I chose the pink color because it matched with the hearts, the text on the Scrapbusting video, and the mail. So that worked well. And then I'm using the smaller end of the Tombow just to add a few little sort of circle-y shapes to pull everything together and to tie it all in. I've been having a little bit of trouble with my fountain pen here. So this was me using it without the whole base part, honestly. Trying to get it to figure out how to get it to work because it's been skipping a lot. And then as you can see here, I got a big of ink all spurted out all at once onto my page. So as you can see, journal pages don't always go 100% the way you're wanting them to when you're making them. So I got all this ink on myself and on the page, and I was trying to use a bit of tissue paper to try and absorb it off, but it is what it is. I got a big splodge right there, and I ended up having to get a wet wipe and try and sort of wipe it off, which pushed it right through, and honestly, it pushed it right through many pages. It now has a big black inky spot that goes through like 3 pages, I think, which is not ideal, but it is what it is. So here I decided I needed to do something about it, so I grabbed out some sticker paper and drew some little stars. Like I said, I was doing a challenge where I couldn't use anything that I didn't make or alter myself. So normally I would have just grabbed 4 regular stickers or something like that, or washi tape, but I didn't have those options. So I had to just come up with something on the fly. This is what I came up with, which is kind of fun, and it worked. And not every page has to be absolutely perfect in our journals. People make mistakes, things happen, you're going to get blobs of ink all on your page at times. And this is just a way I came up with in the moment to try and slightly mask it. I didn't make my star big enough, really, because there is still black peeking out the sides. But I ended up just cutting out all of these stars and sticking them all around the page in different spots here. And I like how they look. I think it looks cute. I remembered that I had this photo also that I'd printed out that I wanted to add on the page, but there wasn't really any space left. So I grabbed a little journal card from my Scrapbusting and journal cards making video that I had made some of these cards, and I grabbed one out and decided I would use one on this page. It seemed to tie in with the fact that I had posted the video this day, and so I stuck my little photo down. Now I have gone and I've done all my writing, all of that is on there, and I had a little bit more to say, so I use the back of that journal card, and I'm going to tip that in on the side. I really do love adding a little tip in wherever I can in my journals. They do make your journals chunky, but man, do I love a good tip in. So just going to stick that photo onto the front there, and I think that is probably about all that happens on this journal spread. I really hope that you have enjoyed this video. I sure enjoyed making it for you. I will see you guys very soon. Next week, in fact, for my next video here on YouTube. And if you are looking for any more videos from me, don't forget that there is Patreon available, and I have a whole lot of videos on Patreon that aren't on YouTube at all. So there's a lot of extra content if you're looking for more. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys next week for my next video. Bye!